least it's not Taco Bell.
We'll do Power Squats.
And welcome back to On the Branch Gaming.
Welcome back. We're doing Power Squats.
We're doing Power Squats.
Is that no cover as in no drink cover for the cover charge?
I would assume so. Well, I assume it's like no cover like to get also, into the bar.
Also, know? That's misleading. It says topless and bottomless, but she's clearly wearing panties.
I know. I hate that. Okay, so this is a funny thing, particularly
wait a second,
in...
Hang on.
What's that?
Oh, you said break. I meant the girl up there. But anyway.
The titties just on display?
Yeah, just a little bit.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, this game is nothing. And look, Charles the Third.
It's that guy.
So this is a funny thing, kind of, and there's just a thing for drag queens.
Because, you know.
Why reasons. Not? But yeah, okay, so here in Vegas, for everyone, you know, listening, interesting enemies, there's kind of a weird dichotomy.
They're sassy, please,
yes.
Ladies.
So there's two types of adult clubs or bars here in Vegas.
Titty bars?
Well, yeah, there's titty bars, which is, they're topless bars. And you're required to be 21 to enter those.
But
if you're 18, you can go to a full nude strip club that does not, you know, openly serve alcohol at the bar. I mean, granted, they might have a bar or something, but you're not required by law to be of age for that. Oh, okay, you just got hit by a bus. There's a cat driving that bus? What?
Yeah, something. Ow.
What the? I think you're going to die.
This acid?
Maybe.
Cheeseburger.
That cat driving the bus is going to hit you. I think you need to get on top of the bus. Or just die.
Was that the bad? In the bad?
Apparently you were in the bad. Trying to get on top of the bus. There you go. Oh, yeah. Okay. I remember what you had to do here. You need to not lose the bus. And you lost the bus. I think you just lose.
Good day, sir.
Yeah, because I know you need to use the bus to get across the thing. So try to get that. Keep that one.
Let me get that cheaper.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe?
Yeah. I think if you go all the way back, okay. So you need to basically prime the engines on this thing.
Like that?
No.
What do you mean prime the engines? Oh, I think I know what you mean.
Yeah, like you have to build it up so as soon as it hits the ramp, it like shoots off.
I know what you're saying now. Yeah. I got it.
Again, those cat drop videos. And then release. There you go.
Jumped it.
Good job.
Just barely.
Yeah. And now we're apparently out of...
Cat's Cafe. It is an actual cat cafe.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they got cats driving the bus and shit, too, so why not, right?
Yeah.
I don't think you can get that. Not from where you are, anyway.
Nope, not in a way that I feel safe to do.
I like how you left the red light district in your repair. Oh, no, you're still in the red light district, apparently.
It's just the yellow light district.
It's the yellow light district?
Yeah, it's caution. It's not, like, danger. Or stop.
Oh, I thought you were making a joke on Asians.
Oh, no. No, that's your own racist mind.
It's the yellow light district.
It's not my fault. You thought it, not me.
Oh, my God.
That's on you. I have nothing to do with that.
Oh, my God. I swear I'm not a bad
person. I don't know why you would think that.
I swear
that.
I'm not a bad person.
You do swear a lot.
I do a lot.
Putties. She's big.
Anyway,
what were we talking about? I don't know, I forgot.
I got off track real fast.
I don't know, it's just something to do with that yellow light district.
Jesus Christ.
Can you not recover from that?
I can't remember what the train of conversation I had in mind was.
I don't know.
I went into this with something in mind.
Save files.
Oh, save files. Yeah. Okay. Okay. We're bringing it back. We're real professional.
We're remembering that thing that we were going to talk about.
So between the break, Meredith and I were kind of briefly talking.
Just taking a minute.
Yeah, just catching our breath. And one of the things we thought was, man, it's really weird how we can't just, like, save the game right now. Like, what if you're, you know, in the middle of doing something, you're just like, oh, man, I gotta go. But, you know, it's like, I can't because my
this
game...
This was back in the days where you just have to leave your game paused.
Yeah. This was back during that strange time where you literally just had to, you know, turn your TV off, leave your game system on, come back, and, you know, pray nothing caught fire during the time, you know, you were out and all that. But you did this super cool move I was trying to teach you this entire time, too.
I did.
And I don't know if I'm happy or sad about this, because, I mean, it's a commonly discussed problem, you know, the way checkpoints are and all that in games these days.
Yeah, Nintendo is like, you know, you take 3 seconds, it's like, you should save your game.
Well, it's you know, it's not even that. Like, Nintendo, for example, does the whole, like, mothering...
You should take a
disapproval
break.
Thing of, it's like, well, I see you've been playing for the last 15 minutes, you know, maybe you should take a break and go outside and stuff. And it's like, no, fuck you, game, I want to play my game.
I see you've been playing for about 2 minutes, you might want to stop for a little bit and go outside and say hi to your friends and family.
Yeah. But I mean, that's one aspect of it. But, for example, just constant checkpointing in current, you know, like modern day gaming and all that. And,
right.
I mean, granted, some of it's different. Some of it's, you know, a little better than that. It's not quite as...
I have no idea what the fuck that just was.
Yeah, good. That's a little weird. But, I mean, yeah, not all games these days are Checkpoint Charlie. And, you know, they're a little more by, you know, your own. And, like, you trigger things, but... I don't know.
Yeah, but save pointing is getting kind of a bit on the ridiculous side of things, where it's like... It's becoming the new Final Fantasy random encounter thing. Like, you take 3 steps, it's like, oh, you're saving now.
That is kind of an interesting way to look at it.
Like, I don't know if we're going to start getting to a point where it's just like, yeah. Where you're just like, you know, your game is just constantly saving and you can't turn off the console.
Yeah, you can never turn it off.
For fear of corrupting your save data.
Yeah, because it's always like, don't turn this thing off.
You've been playing for 39 hours. Do you want to save and take a break?
No.
Yes, because you've constantly been saving.
Speaking of which... But also speaking of which, talking about corrupting save files...
Uh-oh, I don't like where this is going.
This is kind of an interesting lead-in to how Amareth and I even met.
Yeah.
Well, I guess not really met, because, I mean, we had known each other.
How we ended up staying on talking terms.
Yeah, okay, so this is an interesting point, how Amareth and I actually... What the hell?
Well, I bought level 2. It's level 3.
Oh, yeah, I see that. Okay. Beautiful Forever is really cool, and so is Ukami. Like, those are the two things I'd probably say for.
Yeah, I can buy Life. I think I'll buy some Life.
Okay.
But go on with the story.
I think it's only for the next... I don't remember. It feels like it was only for the next stage or something, but...
I don't think so.
The VF Supercharger is also super good.
Yeah, anyway.
Anyway, so back in high school... well, actually, I guess to preface that even further back...
10 plus years ago.
Even further than that, yeah. When I was in fourth grade, I met my friend Adam.
And who Adam eventually became my friend.
Yeah, and Adam, you know, went through the paces and all that and eventually met Amareth here in high school. Now, I did not go to the same high school as Adam and Amareth,
We went to similar high schools.
Yeah. But regardless, you know, Adam was my best friend, and I got introduced to Amareth. You know, we all had kind of a lot of similar interests during the time. You know,
computer
we all into, like...
Computers, gaming.
Yeah, computers, gaming, Japanese anime, just general nerddom, you know, crap. So, I mean, it worked pretty well. I mean, we were never really, really super close friends, I would say.
Well... The story that you're going for, I think, happened on the very first time I met you.
Oh, God. Was that the very first time?
It was Adam's birthday, I think.
Oh, man. Was that actually the first time?
I think it was.
Jeez, if that was, I'm even more surprised. I don't know. I've got kind of a bad memory.
Anyway,
about,
continue about with the story.
Anyway, specific detail like that. Anyway, regardless, on this occasion, It was Adam's birthday, and it was just the three of us over at his house. Now, I know that sounds a little more pathetic and sad than it is, but yeah, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, he had Jewish parents, and they were like maximum three friends only.
Anyway, so we're all over at his house playing before dinner, and we were playing Phantasy Star Online.
Fun game.
The GameCube. Yeah, it's one of my favorite games, you know, I'm sure.
We may play it sometime.
Yeah, maybe. We might do a session. Obviously, we won't probably finish or anything, but it's just like a good, like, just have fun game. For me, it was just a good time killer, space waste, you know, do nothing grind game. And I was okay with that. I was more than happy with this. And at the time, I had a character that was like 100 and... I
think you were 120-something.
Something. I was some obscene like level at the time. Like,
so, to preface, the game has 100, or has 200 levels.
Yeah, you could effectively go to level 200 in this game with a character. So, I had been playing for a while, and, you know, Adam, like, sometimes played with me, but it was always just kind of like...
You know, occasional.
Yeah, like, yeah. I mean, we would usually just do split-screen gaming. You know, I'd come over with my game and my, you know, my GameCube, my memory card. And
back when you would do split-screen, you know, co-op, local multiplayer.
Yeah, which we already have another game that has that, which we'll probably do on the show here at some point. Again, I don't know when all this
could
is airing,
fun.
But... So, anyway, getting back on track for the story. So, I was super high level. I loved, you know, loved this game, played the game a lot, had a very high character, had tons of cool items and stuff.
Yeah.
You know, I was mid-maxing out, and you know, we were playing together, you know, all three of us.
Because mm-hmm. It was the first time I had seen the game.
Yeah. And Amaretha was like, oh, cool, you know, this is a super awesome RPG, you know? Okay. And anyway, so we ended up having to go downstairs
like
for
dinner.
For dinner, yeah, yeah. It was for dinner. And the game, you know, is saving. And I, you know, again, these two were part of the, you know, also the nerd culture or shit that I'm into as well. So I figured, you know, whatever they can handle. I'm like, just turn the game off and all that. So we all go down to dinner, you know, do our thing, blah, 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 blah. And come back up to, you know, to play some more, and there's a problem.
Yeah, what's the problem?
Yeah, well, you know exactly what the problem is.
I just... yeah, but for story purposes, no.
We boot up the game, and, you know, try to load in the characters and all that.
I got a book.
Yeah, you got a book. And the game says the save data is corrupt.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
I damn near lost my shit at that. I'm like, oh my god, what the hell happened?
So, to kind of preface what had actually happened, I own a Dreamcast, and most of the games I know how to save on there. I never actually had a GameCube, and I believe I've talked with Jamie or someone about this. That, yeah, I didn't have any GameCube games until I got a Wii. And that was, like, years later. Which now you kind of understand why that was a problem for me.
I guess so.
Okay.
I thought you had a GameCube, though.
No.
At some
point. I got a GameCube after I got a Wii.
Oh, God, really?
How do I...
I don't know. Figure it out, Amaretha. So, yeah, we come to find out, you know, Amaretha... Did, you know, Amaretha was the one that did it.
Didn't
Amaretha
turned off the game
properly. Well, yeah, Amaretha had turned the game off while it was in the process of saving.
Because I thought it was done.
Yeah.
But it apparently wasn't.
She didn't read the thing which clearly said...
don't turn off the game.
Yeah, it's in the process of saving,
I think I honestly know what happened. It was one of those, like, I hit it as it was saying, okay, saving complete. So I was like, oh, okay, it's good. But
that's
foreboding.
Yes.
Anyway.
Yeah. So I was crushed in that moment. I was like, oh my god, you know, it felt like 14-year-old me had just died a little inside. Right, was 14,
I think you were 15.
15. I don't remember. However old I was at that moment.
Because you're younger than both Adam and myself.
Yeah, by a bit. Anyway, so that's that was the start of it. Is I spent the rest of that evening crushed because this person I had
just met,
literally destroyed one of the beautiful things in life that I loved.
Yeah.
So not exactly the best start to a friendship.
But it has a better ending.
It does?
Yeah. You remember what happened?
Oh, yeah. So, after that, you know, Marathon and I kind of got to know each other a little better. Because of some reason, I decided not to murder her.
Well, because I hadn't seen you for, like, a month because... Just because, well, like you said, we didn't go to the same school or anything. We only really saw each other through Adam. But because of that...
Man, that guy's got a helmet on.
That means he's ultra tough.
Safety first.
Yeah.
And you gotta uppercut the bomb into that thing.
Yeah, so... I had actually spent a lot of time talking with some friends. One of which who had worked at GameStop at a time. And found one of... What was probably the last dial-up adapters back when dial-up was a fucking thing.
Yeah, right.
For the GameCube. Because this game, Phantasy Star Online, had online capabilities.
Imagine that. A game called Phantasy Star Online has online capabilities. Who would have fucking guessed?
Nope, that's not the uppercut button.
No, I think you can blow that wall up, though, anyway. Well, it's like you'll need to time it so it's like it's close to the.
I'm getting it. Hang on. Or at least killing that guy really epically.
Yeah. Right.
Come on, blow that up.
It's a little to the left too. I don't think you're close enough for that. So you just like punch over it. That's too far. You need to not do a
slow mo.
Yeah. Just punch normal. Okay. Now.
Yeah. Nope. All right. Let that one blow up.
Yeah. So good job. Just try a little better this time.
I think that'll work.
Hopefully. Yeah, you did
it. Yeah, I did it.
Remember, there's the one on the right over there, too.
Yeah, okay.
Anyway, so Amareth, on some occasion that we met each other.
It was like a month later, and like I got Adam to like be like, hey, let's hang out one more time, give Amareth another shot. Because they're fucking dumb and didn't mean it. And, yeah, so I got him the adapter. You had online capabilities set up within the next month, like, couple days, I think?
I don't know, something like that. Like, I remember, so you handed me this thing and said, just like, hey, you know, you could actually play that game online now. And I was like, I don't know, at the time I had very mixed feelings. I'm like, I can, but it's like...
Because
care.
All that progress was like, lost. It took you like months to get that high level.
Because I mean, it was a game that I had at the time done a lot with another friend of mine. But yeah, so it felt really weird. It's like, yeah, you could, you know, play online and all, but it's like, yeah, I don't have a character anymore. But I tried it anyway. You know, I took it home, played it for a while, and lo and behold. There's on the game, there's an online mission. Oh, you can only do online, in fact.
Yep.
Hit it mock speed. That it was basically possible just like super level, essentially.
Very super level.
Like to put it plain and simply, that's exactly what it was. And for those of you that might be watching that happen to know, you know, the game, it was Towards the Future.
Yeah, the boss rush level.
TTF, the boss rush mode, was a hell of a thing. I was able to.
It was fun. Like the one time I got to play it, like on your account.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean,
you got up to like 150 within like a month, I think.
Oh, I got ridiculously high like doing that. And, like, it was super cool. So that's the interesting start to how Marathon and I got to know each other, and how I decided I'm like, this person is
not dumb.
They're dumb, but they're not bad.
Yeah.
This, like this.
Come on, jerk.
I don't know. Things just kind of progress well from there, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, it works.
I guess that's the wording we'll go with, is it works.
Is it works.
I think you're gonna get squished.
I hope not. I don't like getting squished. Will you fucking actually shoot that on the ground when I want you to? No, I'll just wait in here. Really? This is being kind of ridiculous. There we go.
Go.
Barely make it. Okay.
Tense moment over.
Jeez.
About a second go. Okay. Now we're not dying.
Good job.
Ooh.
Kind of zoned out there for a bit.
Just had to take a minute.
I even clinched a bit at that. I was like, there you go. You gotta do it down, though.
There we go. Yay.
I'm probably feeding you too much info, but...
Nah. Wow. Well, you're feeding me just enough info.
Oh, yeah. Cheeseburgers. And cheeseburgers.
Love cheeseburgers.
Yeah. I love the cheeseburgers. It's so bad.
I wish I knew how to hit the ones in the background here.
You have to do mock speed. Well, you have to get the after images when you're fighting in mock speed. Because the after images will target the background.
Uh-oh.
Oh,
this guy again.
This guy, yeah.
This Joker. Oops, that was the wrong button.
Yeah, so stun him first and then just go mock speed on his butt.
Come on, get your ass stopping with that.
He is very fabulous, though, by the way.
He is very fabulous. He kind of reminds me of Tuxedo Mask from Sailor Moon.
Kind of. I think it's just the tuxedo.
Maybe. And the mask.
They all really have kind of masks.
Yeah, he's got a mask. He's got a very mask. Do your thing. Come on.
Mock speed.
Yeah. Nope.
Oh, you're almost dead.
Have to be careful, then.
Red hook.
Ow.
Oh, you're dead.
That's not good.
Wow, that was like perfect aim, too.
Yeah, right? He just homed in on me.
It's 360 no scope. Oh, you got to do this again.
360 no scope, no joke.
No Joe.
360 no Joe.
360 no Joe.
I don't see the after effects, though. The after guys.
I mean, you'll know what I'm talking about when you see them.
Probably. But I don't see them.
Like, you specifically bought an upgrade for him, too. Like that's what that mock speed thing is, so.
Yeah, just because I bought an upgrade for it doesn't mean I know what it does. I just know that it's supposed to look cool. Alright, now where's Key Guy? Are you the Key Master or the Gatekeeper?
Well, I suppose it depends on which one of us you're asking.
Ooh. Ow! I really hate these guys, a lot.
Oh, it's the constant rolling. It's how long the animation is, too. That takes
very
really
long.
Yeah.
That, and he is doing the jump shooting thing, which is kind of difficult to hit with. Nope, that ain't gonna work.
That ain't Falco.
Yeah, that'll work, I think. Yeah, that was good much job, quicker. Man.
You did it.
Again.
Okay, so you'll see in there, the after images, wow.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. I'm starting to see.
Yeah, that's what that is.
Yeah, never mind that.
I think we both looked the same thing.
So I think after we kill this guy, next time we kind of lost track of time.
Yeah, we got a little bit off on a tangent there because we both kind of looked down at the clock.
We went into story mode and we're like, oh god, it's been forever.
Yeah, we looked at the clock. And
it can't have been that long.
Kind of looked at each other and then we looked back down and we're like, well,
we're at 15 minutes or something, right?
Something.
It can't be that terrible, right?
It's a little longer than 15 minutes.
Yeah, just a little.
So, Kristen, or,
Or me.
Or you, Meredith, whoever's editing this at the time.
Yeah.
We apologize.
Sorry in advance. Deal with it. get wrecked. Otherwise, I don't know. Words.
Please put in an image of Grumpy Owl.
Yeah, I'm sure Grumpy Owl will make his way into this one. At least once. I gotta get the coins because it's important. Oh, sorry. Not so much cheeseburgers, but coins. I need the V.
Yeah.
I missed the V.
That you did, yes. I was gonna say, don't try to risk a double punch like that.
Nope. Not even close.
Yeah.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
Oh, hey. Those come from?
I don't know, you can get some cheeseburgers up there, though.
I do. A book.
Book.
Okay.
Yeah, other side. I think you're right near the boss, too. But yeah. Do you think we should next time on the branch end? Just so we don't have one massively long episode?
Well, let's see.
Oh man, I wonder what you do here.
Now, this?
Well, considering they were... How are they angled?
Not the way that I'm trying to do.
There you go.
Okay.
I think we should probably next time on the branch those.
Probably.
We'll pick right back up, guys. Don't worry. Although for you, it'll probably be a day, so...
You know,
get
the usual.
Deal with it.